Money Techs Guru. In this video, we are going to learn about basic properties or basic requirements of a die and its classification. Basic requirements of a die. Any textile die, irrespective of its source, it should possess four basic properties or basic requirements. Number one, it should possess a color. It is the primary and very basic requirement of any die. Number two, solubility. It should be easily soluble in water or with the help of any dissolution aid, it should have the solubility nature. Number three, the textile substrates should absorb the dyes and should get retained, or the dyes should chemically react with the textile substrate. Number four, it should possess good fastness properties like color fastness to water, color fastness to washing, color fastness to home laundering, color fastness to crocking, color fastness to light. Classification of dyes. Basically, the dyes are classified based on four different categories. Number one, based on the source. Source means from where the dyes are getting extracted. Number two, based on the type of chromophore present in the particular dye. Number three, based on its solubility nature, whether it is water soluble or water insoluble, based on that category, the dyes are getting classified. Finally, the dyes are classified based on the application technique. What is the technique used to apply that particular dye onto the substrate? Based on that application technique, the dyes are getting classified finally. Let's see one by one in detail. Classification based on the source. Based on the source, the dyes are classified into two types, natural source and synthetic source. Nothing but natural dyes and synthetic dyes. Natural dyes are obtained from natural source. Most are from the plant origin and are extracted from roots, wood, bark, leaves, berries, lichens, flowers, nuts and seeds. And few others comes from insects, shellfish, and some mineral compounds. Natural dyes were the only source of dye until unless the synthetic dyes are discovered in the latter half of the 19th century. The synthetic dyes are manufactured from organic molecules, and the first synthetic dye was discovered in the year 1856. Basically, these dyes are getting manufactured from synthetics or the chemical. Classification based on chromophore. Here, the dyes are getting classified based on the type of chromophore present in the particular dye stuff. Example, nitro or nitroso dyes, azo dyes, triaryl methane dyes, anthraquinone dyes, indigo dyes, etc. What I have provided here is just an example to understand the concept. But actually, many different varieties of chromophores are present in very different dye stuffs. Classification based on solubility. Under this category, the dyes are getting classified into two types, water soluble dyes and water insoluble dyes. Water soluble dyes, example, basic dyes, acid dyes, reactive dyes, metal complex dyes, direct dyes, and solubilized wet dyes. These dyes are categorized under the water soluble category. Water insoluble dyes, which are also called as pigment dyes, which comes under this category, are wet dyes, dispersed dyes, sulfur dyes. For these types, they required a dissolution aid to solubilize in water. Classification based on the application. Based on the application, the dyes are getting classified into five different categories. Number one, direct dyes. Number two, wet dyes. Number three, modern dyes. Number four, azoic dyes. And number five, dispersed dyes. Let's see one by one in detail. Number one, direct dyes. Direct dyes can be applied to the textile substrate, particularly cellulosic textile substrate directly. This is because due to its natural affinity towards the cellulosic fibers. To get an uniform dye, we use an electrolyte, or electrolyte is nothing but a salt, to retard its affinity towards the textile substrate to get an uniform dye. Number two, wet dyes. Wet dyes dye application technique will be quite different from the direct dyes. So it is categorized in the second category. VAT dyes are insoluble in nature. To make it soluble, it's need to be reduced in the presence of alkali to make it a soluble one. So in this soluble stage, the dyes are getting applied to the textile substrate. Once the dyeing is completed, it is then oxidized to make it in original insoluble state. So the dye in the fiber will be in the insoluble state. So the textile substrate which is dyed with the VAT dyes will exhibit good color fastness properties. Number 3, modern dyes. Modern dye application technique will be quite different from direct dyes and VAT dyes. So it is classified in the third category. These dyes can be applied with the help of a mordant. Mordant is a chemical compound that forms a bridge between the textile fiber and the dye. This can be applied, the mordanting can be applied at two stages. Number 1, pre-mordanting. Number 2, post-mordanting. Pre-mordanting means mordanting is done before the dyeing process is being happening. Number 2, post-mordanting. Post-mordanting will happen once the dyeing process is completed. Number 4, azoic dyes. Azoic dye application technique will be different from direct dye, VAT dye and modern dyes. Here, one compound of the dye is impregnated with the textile fabric followed by treatment with another one more compound. Here, two different compounds are required to dye a fabric. The first compound is called as base. The second component is called as naphthol. When these two components, both base and naphthol, getting combined at a particular condition, will form a insoluble large colored molecule in the fiber. Since the dye molecule is formed inside the textile fiber, which gives us very good color fastness properties. Number 5, dispersed dyes. The dispersed dye application technique will be quite different from direct dyes, VAT dyes, modern dyes and azoic dyes. So dispersed dye application technique is classified as the fifth category or the last category. Basically, dispersed dyes are partially soluble in water. So it requires a dissolution aid or a dispersing agent to improve its solubility nature. Basically, the dispersed dyes are used to dye the hydrophobic fibers, and the dye application to the textile substrate will happen at high temperature and high pressure condition, and it exhibits good color fastness properties. I hope this video is useful and informative. Thanks for watching. Please post your comments and doubts in the comments box. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. See you all in the next video. Till then, bye from your Money Techs Group. Bye bye.